Hi friends, welcome back to the channel, and look, your girl is standing for the very first time in her intro. It's kind of weird, not gonna lie, but we shall roll with it. So in today's video, I am here to share with you my February minimalist bullet journal setup. Now, to be honest, this setup is pretty much the exact same setup as my January plan with me video, and that's because usually when I like the spreads I'm using, I'm not gonna go out of my way in creating new spreads for the sake of novelty or for the sake of content creation. I want to show you what I'm really using, what's working for me, what I'm enjoying, in hopes that that can encourage you to find spreads that really suit your needs. But there are some minor tweaks in this setup, so please be sure to keep on watching. Now, if you want to see more bullet journal content, whether that's my advice or more spread ideas, then there are three playlists you can check out. It's all linked in the cards and in the description box. And if you are a fan of chapters or timestamps in videos, then your girl's got you covered. It's all there, all down below. Go check that stuff out. And now, without further ado, here is the setup. Hello, welcome to the setup. So from January's plan with me video, majority of you seem to like me hanging out in the corner. So here I am back again, hanging out in the corner of your screen, journaling with you. So for the first spread of this monthly setup, we are going to start off with, in typical Claudia fashion, with a linear calendar on the left side. Gonna stamp out the word February, then I'm gonna do a linear calendar as usual. It's gonna just be the dates of the month down one column, and then the days of the week down another column, and then we're gonna have a habit tracker on the right side of the page. But first, let's begin with the linear calendar. This is what my February linear calendar looks like so far, and let me show you my January one so you get an idea of how I use my linear calendars. This is what my January one looks like so far, and you can see that it's not really busy. I don't have that much going on at the moment, but also I like to keep it as like simple and plain to see because I use my linear calendars as a bird's eye view for me to reflect and see the month. I only write events and things in my calendar if it is 100% happening or it's already happened. Everything is clear and easy to see. It's easy on the eyes for me. There's not much whiteout going on, and it's not like I'm crossing things out constantly. So I like it like that. You may like it a different way. It's totally up to you at the end of the day. It's your bullet journal, it's your rules. So this is what it looks like when I fill out my linear calendar. And this is what it looks like when it is empty. Part two of the monthly log is going to be the habit tracker. So I'm gonna rotate this notebook. This is how the habit tracker works. I am going to have the title up here. I'm just gonna stamp out habit tracker, plain and simple. And then I'm gonna create a table. And for the x-axis, yes, the x-axis, I did take math. it's gonna be the dates of the month, so from the 1st to the 28th. And I think for this one, this month, I'm gonna include the days of the week, so it's just plain and simple for me. And then on the y-axis, we are going to have all of the activities I am tracking for the month. And you can track as many habits as you want or as little. I highly suggest that you start off small and then develop more over time so that you have a higher rate of success. And yeah, so let me make my habit tracker and then I will explain to you all my habits. Let me walk you through my habits. Firstly, waking up before 8 a.m. I don't always do this, and that's all good. I pray and read the Bible. It's part of my spiritual practice. And then I freshen up, so that's like brushing my teeth, putting on an outfit for the day. Vitamin D, so I take vitamin D supplements every single day. It's really important to me.
And I encourage you to do it as well. Not a nutritionist or a doctor or anything, but we need vitamin D. Prayer journaling, that's what I do every day as well. I bullet journal. Next is physical activity. So whether that's something I do at home from like watching a YouTube video, or it's just going outside for a nice walk. And then I Bible study. And at the end of the day, I like to do a daily tidy. This is really simple, really quick. It's just resetting my workspace, my desk area, just so everything's clear and everything goes back to its home so that tomorrow I can start fresh. And then I shower, do my skincare, and then I do a leisure activity. And then I wrap up my bullet journal practice. So I finish my daily log, I check out my rolling weekly, just wrapping things up. And then I pray again, and then I go to bed before 1 a.m. As you can see, for anyone who is practicing their faith or religion or whatever, I like to incorporate those practices into my daily habits so I can just try to stay as consistent as possible, because I am building a relationship with Yahweh, and I really want to be intentional about it, because a relationship requires me to show up and to allow the relationship to blossom and to develop and to deepen. I pray and I read and I study and I pray some more. And just because I have prayer twice on my habit tracker, it doesn't mean I must pray twice. I pray much more than that. It's just that I don't need to track every single thing I do. This is ultimately a guideline. I don't want you to feel constricted in your habit tracker. This is just really a guideline in what you could do to make your days sufficient and grounded in a routine. Know that I don't always follow this specific structure. I don't always complete it in this order. Some days I might do things down here and then go back up here. It really like depends, but most days I follow it pretty well. It really depends on what's going on in my day. Just give yourself some grace and be patient and try things out. You're never gonna get it right the first time, and it's all a process. It's not about perfection. Also, I do want to show you my January habit tracker so you get a feel for what it would look like when you fill it all out. Here we are. This is what my January habit tracker looks like. And I have a little note section at the bottom that I also kept in my February one, because I want to have some space for me to write down any improvements I can make upon this habit tracker. And I have made some improvements. I encourage you to stay open to tweaking and improving your spreads, because as you grow and change as a person, so will your bullet journal spreads. The next spread is going to be a content creation spread. So you definitely don't have to make this spread if you're not in content creation. All there is to the spread is I'm just gonna stamp out the header, which will say content creation, and then I'm gonna glue on a calendar, which I have right here. This is from Muji. You definitely don't have to buy this. You can definitely create the calendar yourself in your bullet journal. You don't have to be impulsive like me and buy something so cute and then realize, wow, I spent money on this when I could have just made the calendar myself, but I guess I'm just that lazy. And so anyways, now I have it, I gotta use it. So I'm gonna just like paste it right here and then create a little key and then leave the rest of the space for me to brain dump. And that's it. This is my content creation spread. So as the month goes on, this will be filled in. It won't be empty, hopefully. Let me show you what my January one looks like. I won't show you everything. I'll only show you what the calendar looks like, just because I don't want to show you all my brain dumping and brainstorming. It's incredibly messy, and I want to keep my content ideas top secret. This is what we've got. I've got my key, the same colors as I'm using for February. And basically, I will just be highlighting what goes where when I upload and when I post. And then I use the rest of the space to brain dump and brainstorm. The next spread is going to be a rolling weekly. So to all the viewers out there who know this by now, you know the drill, but to those who are new to the term rolling weekly, I do have some videos linked in the cards and in the description box detailing how you use the rolling weekly and what it is and all that good stuff. But just to be super brief, the rolling weekly is basically a spread that you use to just jot down all the activities and things you have to do for the week ahead. Let me make it, and then I will show you some examples of my rolling weekly spreads. So this is the rolling weekly. Yep, that is it. This is the spread. I feel like I'm barely doing anything in this video, but seriously, this is my spread. So we've got the days of the week and the dates. This space right here under this line is where I would brain dump all of the tasks for the week ahead. And then here in this area is where I would just draw a dot to allocate what activity would happen when. So here is an example. I have the rolling weekly on the left side and then begins my daily logs. I've got Monday, which is the start of the week, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. And then I keep going until the next week, and then I start a new daily log. And as you can see, with all the tasks, it takes up about a page. Everything fit perfectly. And now we are on to the last spread of this monthly bullet journal setup, and this is going to be the daily log. So let me just make it for you, and then I'll talk you through how this all works. This is what my daily log looks like. I usually do not write all of my headers on the day. I only have up to here. At the end of the day, I always write a verse for each day, as well as three wins of the day. So a verse is a Bible verse. So depending on what I've read that day or what I studied, I will pick out a verse that I either want to memorize or just really take note of and think about. So I just write a verse there, and then for the wins of the day, this is highlights of your day. So anything memorable, anything that made you smile, anything that you wanna just jot down and remember that that happened that day. As examples, here are my January daily logs. As you can see, I halved my daily log, so I have 2 days worth on one page, and that's because on those days, I just didn't have much going on, so there was no point in me using one entire page for just like 2 things that I had to do that day. And I don't keep it set like this. If I have more stuff going on that day, I will gladly extend it to one full page. Nothing is set in stone. This is really purely organic. I just go with the flow, I go with what feels good, and I'm enjoying the process right now because ultimately bullet journaling is not a means to perfection. This is a practice, it's a process, and you have to really accept the ebbs and flows of this process. And I really do enjoy it when I add in the verses of each day. And what's cool about that is I get to look back on what I was really meditating and reflecting on for that day specifically, because I always write down a verse that really speaks to me, especially speaking to me in what I'm going through. And for example, Tuesday, January 11th, I wrote the verse down, "Count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness," or the word endurance, depending on your translation. And this is from James 1, 2 to 3. And I know I wrote that down because on that day specifically, and really throughout this entire month, 2 months, I've been feeling that my muscle of faith is really being exercised. And in life, you're always going to be given trials and tribulations, challenges and opportunities where you need to produce more faith, or it will reveal your faith. I also am learning that I do not live my life walking by sight. I live my life walking by faith. So just because you don't see the light at the end of the tunnel, or you don't see where things are going, or you can't find a logical reasoning or mental understanding of what the situation is, and you can't quite grasp what's going on, that does not mean you give up or shut down. You just have to keep walking and trust and have faith. And I know that on that day, I was really going through the ringer in that one. So that's why I wrote down that verse. So yeah, that is my daily log. And that's it. This is my February minimalist bullet journal setup. Please do let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. And also please do share with me your bullet journal setup for this month. What spreads do you include in your monthly setups or in your bullet journal in general? Because I would love to hear your thoughts. As always, thank you so much for all the love and support you give to this channel. And I do want to say, sorry, I haven't been like
posting very consistently. I'm still very much growing, and I've been, actually the past couple of weeks, I've made a couple of videos and I was editing them and things weren't working. Like, I was really forcing myself to get stuff out, but then I just knew that the more I was forcing it, the more it just wasn't gonna work. So I knew I had to take a step back and take stock of what was going on. And thank you so much to those who've been checking up on me in the comments and stuff. I really appreciate it. It means so much to me. I'm doing well, I'm all right. I'm taking it day by day. I'm growing, I'm learning. I know that there is a huge transformation going on within, and hopefully it will radiate out when it's time. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what I'm saying, but either way, I'm doing okay, and I am where I need to be right now, and I am so grateful for where I am right now, and I hope that you are too, even if things are tough, and even if you're in a storm and you can't see the light at the end of the tunnel. I pray that you hold fast and stay anchored in where you are and serve in the season you're in, and things will be okay. Just trust. And yeah, I think that's it. That's the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching, and take care, stay safe, stay healthy, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.
On each day, you feel like giving up. I pray you find